I'm feeling myself in this. Oh yeah, there we go. Guess what, guys? Today is going to be an interesting, different kind of video. It combines the love of art and makeup that is here on this channel and combines them into the same video. So, what do I mean by this? Well, I'm going to be showing you my sketching and painting process for this look, which I did right here. And I took two of these looks and made this look. And I am using the Art Nouveau collection by Kailav Beauty. And I am going to put this up so that you can see it. She kindly sent these over to me. And so I will be giving you my first impressions thoughts and testing them out and swatching them and everything. I'll actually put up some swatches up here. And I did tease this on Instagram. So I'm very active on my Instagram. So make sure you follow me over there. But this is the collection itself. And she was very, very kind to send this to me because a couple weeks ago in my new makeup releases video, I said that I had my heart set on getting this, both of them, and what happened was I had to take my cat to the vet, and unfortunately, they have raised their prices since inflation and everything, and it was $225. So, she kindly sent these to me, and I was just like, oh my god, thank you. and really, it was touching. So thank you so much, Kailav, and I am really, really excited to show you guys what this is all about. So let's take a look at this particular palette. Now, what we see here, some of you might be like, oh, well, it's a rainbow palette. And I'm like, yes, it is a rainbow palette, but it's not just a rainbow palette, okay? To me, this is an opportunity as an artist, plain and simple. So I'm really excited to use this, and I'm going to be using it more on Instagram. And then we also have, by the way, this is, for those of you who don't know anything about art history, this is by Gustav Klimt, and I think it's Klimt or Klimt? I don't know. Anyways, it's called The Kiss. I actually have a print of this.
Guys, if you do want to receive 10% off, I do have an affiliate code with Kailav. It is Jane10. You can use that at checkout, and I really appreciate it if you want to get this set and you decide to use that. Okay, folks, I guess my reasoning just left the building at this point because I can't find the rest of this clip. So, oh, I know I'm a quality YouTuber. I do have a print of The Kiss, but you can just Google it. Here's the palette close up. And I wanted to show you the paint palette too, which is in collaboration with Josie, aka Sunshine the Bee on Instagram. And she does very artistic looks. And so for my artists, you got to go check her out. But look at how beautiful this palette is. It is so vibrant. And I can't wait to play with it more. It's just absolutely gorgeous. So as you can see, we have some artwork inspired by Alphonse Mucha, who is a very, very famous Art Nouveau artist who had basically depicted women with like flowing dresses and lots of curled embellishments for advertising at the time. And so in this particular book that I'm about to show you, you know, it shows some of his works and you can see how it inspired that work of art. So you can clearly see where that inspiration came from. And Mucha is one of my favorite artists as well. So many of you know that it's been a while since I've sat down and recorded anything on camera of me sketching or painting. And I got to thinking about what I wanted to create with this set of palettes because we have a lot of beautiful bright colors to work with here. And I actually found this process to be very inspiring and got me even more excited to play with a palette. So I love drawing and painting eyes. They're just my favorite thing to do. And they're my favorite part of the face, and they're kind of like canvases all their own to create. So I actually used my own eyeball as a reference whenever I didn't have any eye makeup on. And I just used an HB pencil and a kneaded eraser here to sketch out different angles that I've of pictures that I've taken for Instagram or for whatever. So I thought, you know, it might be kind of fun to sit down and just try to envision what I could possibly possibly create. And this here is Holbein gouache, and I absolutely love this gouache because it has no whitening agents, so whenever it dries down, it doesn't lose its vibrancy or it doesn't shift in color. A lot of cheaper brands will put filler and whitening agents in, and so the colors shift. But I really was excited to use this because it was like this particular one right here, you know, you can clearly see that I'm pointing towards the paint palette as inspiration there. So I will create that. I didn't end up creating that look by itself, but I ended up kind of creating a hybrid between two of these looks that I created, painted. But I might use basically one of these other looks that I painted here for something on Instagram. I really found this process to be inspiring and relaxing. I actually initially started sitting down with makeup and playing with makeup because it also relaxed me. And I find it very therapeutic, much like I find art therapeutic. So this is why these two particular things are so perfect for this channel. And I feel like they work so well together. And I know that YouTube has an algorithm that doesn't like to promote two different niches. And yeah, they're technically two different ones. But to me, makeup is art, as I've always said. And it's a fun process to be able to sketch out your looks. And I don't see why people aren't doing this more, you know? So I'm kind of like, let me do it. I'll do it. Please keep in mind, this is not my best work by any stretch. I have plenty of other art supply reviews and tutorials here on the channel that reflect my more serious, quote unquote, paintings. This is more of a sketching process and getting my hands in the paints. I actually want to bring face chart art into the mix here, and I want to paint with makeup, but I also want to paint a look with actual paint and see if I can translate that onto my face. But this was truly so much fun to do, and I highly encourage it, especially if you've hit a creative block with your makeup or you just want to challenge yourself. So I added some Holbein Artist colored pencils on top to just refine the details here, and eventually ended up using a small nail art liner brush to create lashes here in a moment that you'll see. And if you all want some tips on drawing eyes, I'd be happy to make a video sometime.
Lift, and oh, it's the Color Fix. It's called Lift, but you know what I'm saying. So I decided to go ahead and wear this shirt because it's got all of, like, the colors of the palette in it, and I don't really know which one I want to do. And you know, this is just kind of a loose idea. These are not necessarily going to be exactly to the T, but I really do like this one. I do want to do this at some point, but I really like this, and I've been wanting to get Water Serpents, this blue, on my eyes ever since I saw this and it came in the mail. So I think I'm going to start with that one. And look at all these pretty colors. Look at all of them. But also, they stain. So if you're planning on doing something like on the face itself, just keep that in mind, okay? Especially the ones that have like the purple, this purpley blue one, that definitely stains. The second one, the pink one, is obviously going to stain. Anytime that you have something that's got red or pink pigments in them, red technically, it's going to stain. I don't know why, but it does. Taking Water Serpents on a Refer 27, this is the first time I'm using this because Refer has a sale going on right now and I love their brushes. This is the fluffiest brush around. Wow, okay. There's no turning back. Wow, okay. I was not expecting that much pigment to come out all at once, because fluffy to me equals like diffused kind of, but wow, okay. We're doing this. I'm okay with that. I do like to sometimes build the color up, but I do like things to be pigmented too, so look at me, I'm complicated. And I was looking through my Alphonse Mucha book, and I don't know if you guys know this, but I'm sure some of you guys know this that are fellow artists, but Alphonse Mucha and the other folks that were in the industrial or in the Art Nouveau movement were also creating this art because the Industrial Revolution brought a lot of like smoke and a lot of, well, industrial complexes, all kinds of buildings that were in the, kind of ugly. And so it was their response to the Industrial Revolution, kind of gross architecture, basically, very primitive architecture, kind of cold and sterile. And so they wanted to create something that would bring some life back into architecture and culture. So if you notice, especially with Alphonse Mucha's work, it's very curvy, it's very feminine in that sense. There's a lot of curves, there's a lot of elegance to it. Not that men can't be elegant, but you know what I mean. Ooh, that blended out really, really nicely. That diffused well. Taking a Blend Bunny 5 and just building up that color here. Also, there was a graphic design element to Mucha's style. If you notice, a lot of the time there's, French writing and everything like that. They didn't have Photoshop back then. They didn't have Adobe Illustrator back then. So a lot of these advertisements turned out to be part of the Art Nouveau movement. So, okay, for instance, the back of this is Job, or whatever it was called, Job. As you can see, she's got it. Take this little blending brush from Give Me Glow. This is a 327, G327. I'm going to go into Mystique and deepen up this crease right in here and into the socket. Ooh, that's a nice purple. Ooh, yeah. Gotta make sure I'm in like that box that it's focused on, because that would not be good. Oh, did I do that thing again where I go too far out? Maybe I did now. I can save it. I can save it. You know why? Because it's art and we're putting it on my face and I can do what I want.
I do what I want.
But seriously, I love art history. I love learning about artists and what their process was. And I say was not just with classical artists, I mean artists that are still alive too. But classical art is pretty cool. That blending brush again and just kind of. We can put a rhinestone there or something. We can paint over it or something with the paint palette. We're good. We are good. I'm gonna take that Blend Bunny 5, and I'm gonna go back into Water Serpents and just kind of make sure that it doesn't get lost. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it is my technique or what, but I always seem to kind of want to go back over it in this area. So I guess because this area right here is slightly hooded, so just at certain angles. And so I don't want to lose it. It's just the way I operate. I should probably just plop everything on and then blend it later. But the artist in me doesn't want to do that. I want to take a Blend Bunny 2 and take Rouge and, or I'm sorry, Klimt. Gustav Klimt. Klimt? Is it Klimt? I hope I said it right. I want to put it on the inner part here. I didn't want to put green on it because these two are going to make green anyways. So, I mean, we might still, but I don't feel like doing it. Ooh, it makes a nice green. Lets me know it's nice and blendable. There's nothing more satisfying like when you're painting and you get these, especially with oil paints, and you get these beautiful colors to blend together, there's nothing more satisfying than that, especially if it's what you wanted, like the color that it blends into is the color that you wanted to for it to create. Oh, so good. Fewer things in life are that satisfying. I just feel like bringing it down a little bit more because we can. This is not going to be your typical eyeshadow palette review. This definitely is not going to be your typical like eyeshadow palette look. This is not an everyday look, okay? Are any of my looks everyday looks? Probably not. But yeah, this is just gonna keep one to... I forgot him again. I forgot Frankenfurter. It's because I do ads, and so when I'm filming ads, I can't have Frankenfurter in the background, unfortunately. There, okay. So that'll work. I'm just going to keep kind of diffusing this out like towards my temples. That way it kind of has this sort of light, airy feeling. And of course, it adds to the art of it all. This is so, like, I would love to make this a series, like where I basically take the world of art and makeup and bring them together and do something kind of pre-planned, sort of, but not enough for it to be like stifled at all. I don't want to like create the art and then be like, I don't know. I have to do it to the T, because then that kind of defeats the purpose of creativity. So that's why these sketches are just kind of a loose guide, although I will do the other one probably to a T. Taking that Mystique color, and I'm just going to tap it. Blend, tap, right here on the outside. And I don't want to go too far in because then it'll blend with that green, and we don't want that. Those are two secondary colors. That'll make mud. I don't know what it is with me and flicking it out, but I always want to flick out my eyeshadow. I guess it's just habit. I do wish that there was like... I mean, there is an ultramarine kind of blue here in this shimmer, but I wish there was one in a matte, but no biggie. I really love this blue. Really love it. All right, I'm going to take that Mystique color with a Sigma E45, and I'm going to put it in my outer V. So my neighbor, who's 85, he's really good about knowing that when I'm filming, he can't sing. He does this, it's not really singing. It's more like a, I mean, sometimes he does sing. It's more of a droning kind of thing. But God love him. He plays this casino game, okay? And I'm going in at a diagonal here, but he plays this casino game, and everything that he does in the garage, you can hear very, very well on that microphone. So right now he's actually outside talking on the phone, on the speakerphone. Hopefully you guys can't hear too much, but it's our cat Jack and him, and he's talking on the speakerphone. I love him so much. He's the best neighbor I've ever had. I hate doing that, though. I really hate doing that. But he's really good-natured, and that's what makes him one of the best neighbors I've ever had. We watch out for each other, and he looks after... The cat adopted him, kind of, after his dog died. But, okay. We are going to go... What are we going to do? I want to get some green on my eyes, but first I'm going to have to put that blue in between the green. Let's get the green on, and then I'll blend the blue over it. But this fluidity color, so pretty. It's like a grass green. Take that same Sigma E45 and do it kind of like this. Huh? We gonna do it? We gonna do it? Can we do it? We can do it! Oh! Yeah. That's great. Awesome. Uh-oh. What did I do? I think some of the purple just got in the wrong spot. Oh no. You know what? I may have to do a little miniature pseudo cut crease here. Just to cover that, because I don't want it to get muddy in this one spot. It's gotta look clean. You see where it's kind of getting muddy there? That was my fault. Right there. Yeah, we go. There we go. All right, let's try it again with fluidity. This time, hopefully, everything will be okay. Okay, I'm going to do a diagonal again. And I'm going to place it right next to the purple. I don't want it to interfere with the purple. See, it's a cool toned green, kind of. At least it looks cool toned to me. And that purple, oh my god, that's such a good purple. Purple is one of the hardest colors to formulate in eyeshadow, but that purple, oof. And it's not too cool toned, it's not too warm toned, it's like right in the middle, right in like a classic purple. So now that we have the green down, I'm going to take something. And take something here. Where is it? And take a Blend Bunny 3 and take Water Serpents and just kind of stick that in between the purple and the blue, or purple and the green, so that we have a gradient and those two secondary colors don't turn out to be muddy. I'm just going to tap it on. Do it this way. It was so beautiful today that I didn't want to come down here and work. So I basically used the art as an excuse to open my garage door. Because whenever I'm filming, like now, the garage door is closed. Because otherwise you guys would hear cars going by and all that good stuff. This is really blending very well together. It's just blending by not like physically doing any kind of blending motions. It's just tapping. Yeah. Dude, that's nice. Taking that lovely summer green and putting that on a Real Techniques brush. Nice. You know what? Let's try my finger. That's better. Yeah. I sometimes hesitate to use my finger with shimmers sometimes because I know that I can hit that place in the pan where it becomes a hard pan like pretty easily. Because I am a heavy-handed person, I'm a heavy-handed artist, I'm a heavy-handed eyeshadow person, and so whenever I'm like, you know, there's going to be some oils for my fingers getting in that. So, wow. It looks really pretty. I like it. Okay, now my two neighbors are talking. Outside. Together. Hey, the world does not stop just because I hit record, but I'm just letting you guys know, I am not trying to record in a purposefully louder environment. I wish that I could say I could soundproof this garage, but I am not able to. I'm going to take just that Mystique color, just kind of tap it right here. I am going to bring it down a little bit more here in a second, but first I want to put down Water Serpents. What am I doing? Story of my life. What am I doing? And this is a BH Cosmetix
smudge brush. I'm going to take it almost all the way in, but not entirely. Because I'm going to put either yellow, I'm probably going to use that yellow color again. And I'm going to use something that I've been wanting to use for a long time, but I didn't have my hands on it. It's just the smallest, tiniest refer brush. And I'm going to just plop it right there. Right there. Gonna make green with the yellow and green because children, that's how color works. A lesson in color theory. If you guys want me to, I will kind of talk to you guys a little bit how you can create eyeshadow looks much like an artist does. Not necessarily a makeup artist, but an artist. A fine artist. Because let me tell you, it can help you, especially if you're wanting to kind of dive into color and you don't really know where to get started. I mean, it helps to have a rainbow palette, but you wouldn't necessarily have to have a rainbow palette. But I can make a video about it. We want to look artistic, and it doesn't matter if we look like a clown, but that's not what I'm aiming for. I think I already failed that, but okay. Ooh. Maybe we'll put this on my inner corner. Such precision with this brush. Okay, it's time to dive into the paint palette. Okay. Ever since I saw the teal shade, I thought, I gotta get this on my face. So, I'm just gonna, you know, maybe draw a circle. I played with it yesterday. So, just the swatches. And, oh Lord, what do you want?
Hi, honey, what are you doing? What you doing, sweetheart?
It's a consistency game. I'm curious to see if it's going to be like opaque right off the bat, or because it's pretty opaque, but it also, it's like any kind of like water activated liner. Like you gotta make sure it's not too much water, not too little. Gotta be like the right consistency. Can she do a circle? Am I going to create an entire painting on my face? No, not right now. I'm not at that level. On my face, at least. And I gotta admit, I was pretty rusty on my sketching today. Also, I'll be using these brushes from Royal and Langnickel. This is part of a set that is a detail set. And I'll link it down below because I figure somebody's gonna want to figure out what I'm using. But you know what also works? Nail art brushes. I have a nail art brush set that I use simply for my face. And then I'm also going to buy a second set for painting. So, painting. Not just painting my face. I'm probably going to speed up some of this painting of my face because I don't really know exactly all that I'm going to do. What I really want to do is create that painterly eye with the teal, the pink, the purples, and the peach. That orange is really pretty too. I can hear the other cat. The other cat's meowing. Do you hear him? I want to get this gold on my face too. Oh no, am I gonna look like the crow? Did I just goof? I don't know. I kinda wanna just like do shapes and stuff. Shapes and stuff. So much fun. Do I wanna do something on my forehead? I don't know. Myself. So I just decided to kind of roll with it and try not to take it too overboard. I don't know. To some people, I know this is way, way past their comfort zone. I love it. I wouldn't mind going to the grocery store right now. I know I look like a crazy woman, but you know what? It's art and I'm an artist and I can get away with it that way. So I just want to tell you guys what's on my face. In addition to all this, I have got, where'd it go? This right here, this is Space Paste. This is by Lemonhead LA. It is, the actual shade is Houdini. It is the Euphoria glitter. It is actually not just the product that they use on Euphoria, but it's the shade that Rue wears. And so it's kind of this iridescent, well, you can see it. It's kind of a purpley blue iridescent. And the reason that this is a little bit pricier than most glitters is because it's removable very easily and you can use it on the eyes and you can kind of shape it and mold it to the way that you want it to work rather than just kind of like the water-based glitter gels that you're used to. So that's a whole other can of worms we can open some other time. But I put this Shockwave neon liner, and I might put it back in, I'm not sure, but my eyes were starting to get a little bloodshot whenever I used it, so I went ahead and just took it out again, or took it off, not took it out. So I also decided to use Space Age Prophecy, the duochrome highlighter from Kaleidos. I am using that over here, kind of a little bit lower than what I'm used to, and on my nose, and I just thought, might as well, you know? What else did I use? Let's see. Oh, I used the Strawberry Jam Blush by Physicians Formula. Unfortunately, the little strawberry pattern is no longer with us. So, and the wonderful Bye Bye Panda Eyes by Essence. I decided not to put falsies on. I don't usually wear a lot of falsies, only for dramatic effect. And then I have like an everyday lash that I might wear. But for this look, if you look closely, okay, I'm gonna scoot in. Hello. I'm wearing some cobalt blue liner. I use a little bit of that lilac shade for wings on the edge, and I generally just didn't want to cover that up with falsies. So that is, oh, even trying to get it off my eyes is a little tough. So this is the dollar version of it, and so I decided to go ahead and use this one instead because it's vivid and I can easily remove it. So, and let's see what else. My good old Peekaboo Neutral by NYX, and Oh, Butter Gloss in Maple Blondie. I figured there's kind of that peachy shade. It can match everything. And so there you have it. There you have it. So that's what I'm looking like today. And also, I decided to change my shirt because, da-da-da, it's Alphonse Mucha. It's a Mucha Art Nouveau shirt. So I figured, hey, it's all going to work together. And yeah, it came together very serious. Okay, thoughts on the palette. So far, so good. I really, really was impressed with how lovely it blended because this is my first time trying this brand. So this particular blue and the yellow, they blended so well into this wonderful green shade. I didn't even have to put green in between. It was just awesome. And the purple blended very well with the blue. And so I want to play with it a little bit more. I technically do like a palette roundup or like a monthly haul type of thing. I don't think I did it last month. I can't include this in it yet. So it'll be in a few weeks. You'll see more of a final thoughts, a better, well-rounded opinion. But so far, it is a lovely blendable palette, and it's buildable, and it's pigmented, but it's not so pigmented that you can't blend it out, if that makes sense. I feel like this is a nice rainbow palette, but I don't see it as a rainbow palette. I see it as like as if I were looking at a paint palette, and I think about like, okay, well, what's gonna blend into what? I really enjoy the palette. I think it's a lovely high quality palette. I don't see how, like, okay, so I can see where like the artists out there are going to enjoy this. Okay, not only that, but you know, if you're a fan of color, you're definitely going to love this. This is not for everybody though, and I recognize that. Like, I feel like it would be a nice companion palette to those of you who maybe you have a lot of neutral palettes and you want something with a pop of color. You want a dependable like palette that's not too big, not too small, with like bright colors in it, and you want something that's a little on the rainbow side because maybe you don't necessarily want to have to go through 10 palettes in order to find the color that you're looking for. You just want a solid orange metallic or a solid purple, you know, so that for that reason, it is a lovely palette and that could work out for you in that sense. I feel like, of course, if you love color, you're gonna love this naturally. I love the fact that it's not just a rainbow palette though. I like the fact that we have sort of these, like this blue in particular, I'm in love with it because when we see rainbow palettes, we tend to see like more deeper blues, and this is a nice solid blue matte. And then I love the fact that we have this gold here that's like this antique gold. I would maybe get rid of this shade and put in like a fuchsia or like a metallic or matte magenta color. That's just me though. Because for whatever reason, I think of like opera pink. And for those of you who are just watching my channel, simply for makeup, opera pink is like a hot pink. And sometimes they call it opera rose in paint. And it's very, very vividly magenta. And I think that would make just a lovely like piece here, you know? And so we have this sort of plummy purple, but it's not quite opera. So that's just me personally, but I love the fact that she does have a nice black in there. That is something that a lot of palettes lack. They need a black in them, and it's a good solid black. It's not, you know, pseudo black or charcoal. It's black. It's definitely like dark as night black. So that's what I like about this palette a lot. Now, the paint palette, I love. I'm in love with it. Now, I love this one too. This is a very, very solid palette. In fact, I would love to see more of these in her brand. I would love to see like a series of these with different color stories in them. But I love this color story. I love that we have this beautiful gold here, and these are so vivid, okay? I did notice that whenever I used the teal and the pink, they did make a nice kind of lilac purple. I mean, we already have a lilac purple, but I did notice that, like, if you wanted to keep these sheer, you could probably see them blend into other colors and more like a watercolor approach to painting with them. So I love this. I'm going to cherish this forever. This is beautiful. And so I'm going to cherish this forever and ever. Thank you so much.
Kailav. I really, really appreciate Kailav for sending me these and being so generous to send me these, because it was very, very thoughtful the way that it all played out, and I really, really appreciate that. And so I'm looking forward to playing with these both. All right, it is late. My brain is kind of shutting down. So I'm very hungry. I will talk to you guys later. I hope that you've enjoyed this type of video. If you do, let me know in the comments below. I would love to continue to do this art and makeup thing in one video. Of course, I have art and makeup here on this channel, but you know. And if you did like the video, give it a thumbs up. Feel free to subscribe if you enjoyed this kind of video. I will be bringing you more art and makeup content. All right, guys, have a wonderful night. I'll see you later. Bye. I hope that wasn't too rambly, because it's late. Give me a break, okay?